Hey everyone, Iridium T here, and welcome back to Let's Play Life is Strange Before the Storm. Last part, we did some D&D, got the skull, and all that stuff, and now let's head up the stairs. And head inside. Oh, hi.
Good. You're here.
I guess. I guess I'm here.
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda, indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... Many a time... The harmony of their tongues hath I listened to.
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Keaton, sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome. This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite, Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective.
Why me?
The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
It's true love, I guess.
Sometimes, when you meet someone who's going to change your life, you just know it, I guess. Also, you've got parents coming to see the show, right? At 20 bucks a ticket, it's gotta be true love.
Wow. A romantic and a cynic. That actually kinda helps me. Thanks.
Yeah.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Don't mention
later.
It.
See you later, guys.
Oh no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
I'll just be a minute.
Okay, so why am I here again?
Oh, could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
Sure.
This is sudden.
Okay, get the belt. Don't say any stupid shit and don't, like, fall down. Should be doable, right?
Also, don't leave. Alright. What do we got around here? Anything we can really examine? Let's find out. Props. Dish.
If I'd known acting meant getting to play with weapons, I totally would have auditioned for the Tempest.
Mm-hmm.
I guess the Prescott donation doesn't cover this.
Guess not.
Should be life is drama.
Life is drama. Yeah.
Sweet collar, Pepe.
Mm-hmm. What do you got here?
Hey now. Sharing is caring.
It is. Sharing is caring.
I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings. Why do theater kids take themselves so seriously?
Yeah, Nathan Prescott's in it. Dana, Hayden, Juliet, Travis. Okay. Alright, there's the bag. What is this?
RA will suck as Prospera. If VC had any talent, maybe she would have gotten the part.
Talent? Is that what got Mr. K to cast you, slut?
Guess they don't call it drama lab for nothing.
No kidding. Let's comment. Sounds like a good plan.
What to say? What to say?
Bitter much?
Playing the part of the bitter, passed over, talentless hack, VC.
Yup. Was that not the next graffiti? I guess it wasn't,
this
apparently.
This poster definitely says something.
Mm-hmm. Alright, let's search.
Rachel looks so happy here. There's Rachel's belt.
Chloe!
Guess I'll go give this to Rachel now. Suck a D, VC.
Mm-hmm. Prison wall. Drama nerds. Shouldn't that have been it? Unless I chose the wrong one. It's possible. I don't know. Alright.
We must be 100 costumes in here. Am I the only student who's not in this show?
Oh, here we go. Graffiti. Halo for Rachel. Where was number 5? That's a good question.
Save my life. Get some ink.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was drama nerds. Huh, I don't know where prison walls was.
Must have been outside somewhere. Just gotta turn up the heat.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna guess it's from Logan.
Yeah, probably. I guess I'll have to go back and clean up that
Rachel?
One.
Is this
what happens when you go blind,
yes.
I guess.
Thank you. Here you go.
Ow! I didn't say attack me with it.
Shit. Sorry.
Maybe you didn't want to go back there.
Chloe Price.
Rachel Amber.
Last night was amazing.
Getting attacked was amazing?
You call getting attacked by goons amazing? I've got to hang out with you more.
Deal. To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Maybe it doesn't.
Maybe it doesn't.
I was trying to think where that one could have been.
Exactly.
I explored the whole area.
How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
Have you gone rogue?
Ditch class. You mean it?
Is that weird?
No, it's awesome.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Sounds good.
Sure you don't want to just grab the bus, or...
Nope. If we're gonna go rogue, we're doing it right.
Oh, I see.
Well,
what the hell am I getting into here?
go. North? Maybe we'll end up in Seattle.
Maybe.
Pull up a chair, Price. The view's amazing.
Rachel wants me to pull up a chair. Maybe one of these crates. Guess we're not the first ones to hop on this train. I wonder what the symbols mean.
I don't know. I had a text though. I went through, people were saying you were awesome. Why aren't you and Kim? Talk later. Okay.
Whoa, Nathan's dad is a Terminator? That totally checks out.
See.
I feel pretty confident there's going to be a dead body in here.
What do we got? Moving canvas. So that's gonna be probably on here somewhere. But where? Unless it's after it stops.
Just another typical day. Skipping school. With Rachel Amber.
It's not there. I don't know. Let's just move it.
Thing's heavier than it looks.
Oh, I should get back here now. Graffiti?
I see humans, but no humanity. Everybody is somebody, but no one wants to be themselves. Some preachy graffiti up in this train.
Let's add our own. That sounds good to me. Everybody lies.
Everybody lies. I like that.
Alright. What's this?
I was supposed to read Huck Finn in English last year. Now I'm living it. Price 1. Twain 0.
Interesting place to leave it. Alright. Jim Bob's a thief. Okay. So what's our next one? So we've got dead white guy. Happy brat, old car. Alright. Let us sit down.
Chloe, you're on a freaking train with Rachel freaking Amber. Play it cool. Is this nervousness? Is that what this feeling is? Wish Max were here, so I could ask. Should I make small talk? Is that what people
just
do?
Just stay silent. Nice
it's
weather?
Nice weather we're having.
What?
The weather? It's nice.
It's always the awkward conversation starter.
It sure is.
So, it's kind of weird that we're hanging out.
You mean because I don't hang out with anyone and I don't have any friends?
You have friends.
Well, I used to. Friend. Singular. Her name was Max, but she left for greener, more northern pastures.
That sucks.
Say thanks.
Hey, so, I want to say thanks.
For pulling you out of school?
No, dummy. Thanks for last night. If you hadn't shown up.
Assholes abound in Arcadia Bay.
I owe you. That's for sure.
Is that why you came along?
Are you suggesting I should need a reason to ditch school?
I think she was looking for any excuse to ditch.
The thought occurred, yeah.
Well, I wanted some company.
That's it?
That's it.
I love company.
Good to fucking go. Anything beats another second in Blackwell.
You really hate it there, don't you?
You don't? Right. What reason would Rachel Amber have for hating Blackwell Academy? Your high school royalty.
You don't know me. Yet.
Yet.
Let's do something fun.
Okay.
Okay. I'm listening.
Two truths and a lie.
What?
I think we should play Two Truths and a Lie. It's a game where each person offers up three facts about themselves, two of which are the truth, and one of which is
a lie.
Right. And then the other person has to guess which is which.
Sure.
Sounds fun.
Okay.
You're on.
I'll start. First, I'm ambidextrous. Second, I was born in New York, the land of fashion and Broadway, to which I will one day return when my heinous exile here in Arcadia Bay comes to an end.
New York, huh? I've never been.
Mm-hmm.
Not a world traveler?
Not yet, at least.
If you could travel anywhere, where would you go? Russia, Greece, Kathmandu?
Kathmandu?
One day, I'm going to climb Everest.
And I thought moving away from Arcadia Bay was ambitious. What's your third thing?
My third thing?
Two truths and a lie. You say three things.
Right. I'm a Leo. Meow.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So, ambidextrous, born in New York, and a Leo. Gotcha.
So, which is the lie?
New York?
You seem more like a Cali girl to me.
Damn, Price, not bad. Long Beach, in fact. West Coast is the best coast.
I've only ever lived in Oregon, so nothing to compare it to, I guess.
Then we'll have to change that one day, won't we? Okay, your turn, Price.
First fact. Right. Something about myself.
Something.
Should I start things off with a lie or with the truth? Or should I cheat? Let's see how good she really is at this game.
A truth. I love science.
I love science. Seriously, I think Neil deGrasse Tyson is the shit.
Huh.
Let's go with a lie. I'm allergic to cats.
Sad to say this, since you're a Leo and all, but I'm allergic to cats.
Are you now?
Swear.
And the truth. I want to be a pirate.
I used to want to be a pirate when I grow up. I kind of still do.
Arr.
So which is it?
You're hella mysterious, Chloe Price.
Hella?
Who says that? It's a Cali thing. Anyway, I think I have your number. Of course you wanted to be a pirate. Sail the open seas.
Buckle swash.
Plunder secret treasure. So, pirate. Obviously true.
Okay. Arr.
Like you said.
Arr.
Okay. You say you love science, but you are failing chemistry.
You're saying failing chemistry means I hate science?
Or that Blackwell doesn't inspire your best work.
It's a hellhole.
That place is a hellhole filled with shit, where shitty people go to be shitty to each other and themselves.
Tell me how you really feel, though. Anyway, School sucks, but you love science. I'm gonna say true.
Oh no, she's on to me.
Which brings me to your alleged cat allergy.
Alleged?
I'm calling lie.
Why is that?
I mean, maybe you're allergic. But I've passed by your locker a few times. And I've seen that old photo of a cat you keep in there.
Stalker much?
You've passed by my locker? Stalker much?
Hey, I notice things. I can't help it.
I guess you're no stranger to being noticed, too. It's kind of new for me.
Well, get used to it. So, if my math is correct, you told me two truths and one lie.
Of course.
You expected me to cheat?
Winners make their own rules, Chloe.
You are crazy good at this game.
A lifetime of studying the human condition.
I'm impressed.
Well, I'm impressed.
I bet it's hard to impress Chloe Price. I'm gonna feel good about that one. When your dad is the district attorney, I guess lying is something you're used to.
Seriously?
Seriously.
I know who to call if I need to get out of a ticket then. Not that I have a right of my own. Car first, embarrassing number of moving violations second.
Hey, thanks for trusting me.
Trusting you?
Yeah, you kind of saved me.
And not everyone would admit to wanting to be a pirate.
But eye patches are so cool.
And rum is delicious. I guess. You opened up a lot. That's all.
It's not a big deal.
Hate to break it to you, but Chloe Price is not exactly renowned throughout Arcadia Bay as a bastion of trust and empathy.
It's hard.
Trust doesn't exactly come easy to me. Maybe if you'd had my life, you'd understand.
No, I get that.
On the other hand, I got on this train with you, didn't I?
Fair point.
Wouldn't mind listening to some music.
Music time? Let's share it.
Hey, wanna listen?
Mountains really are pretty when they aren't on fire. How would know? Let's keep it moving.
Cool bracelet. I've had it, I guess, since I was a kid in Long Beach. It reminds me that there's more to experience out there than just Arcadia Bay. Maybe one day I'll go back to Long Beach. Or anywhere but here. Maybe sooner than later.
I hear ya.
Me too. Arcadia Bay can suck a bag of dicks.
Sometimes, I feel like I've got no reason to stay. Don't be surprised, Chloe, if one day, I'm just out of here.
Let me know if you need an accomplice.
Check it out! We're here!
What?
Where is here? Jump and find out! Did you say jump? Jump!
Okay, fine. Well, jump! Jeez. Now that we jumped, are we dead? Probably not. No, we're okay. Hey, this is cool. Apparently. apparently a lot of people hang out here. That seems like a really random place.
Hey, it's actually a pretty nice view. Glad you approve. And as your reward for making it up here, I have a new game for us to play.
Another game?
I like games. Deal with it. This is one I learned in theater class. It's all about improvisation.
So far, what I've learned about you is that you're into acting, lying, and playing games.
What's your point?
That you're either full of imagination or full of shit.
Let me know when you figure out which one. This game involves spying on people from afar. Luckily, we've got some high-tech surveillance equipment right here. Let's fire it up.
All right. Super high tech, huh?
That blows. Well, shit.
That was my last quarter. You?
Quarterless. Damn.
Well, so much for that idea.
Maybe I can MacGyver something up. I've been told I'm pretty handy.
Oh, yeah? Let's see what you got.
All right.
Rachel really wants to use this viewfinder. I'd love to get it working for her.
What's the next one? Dead white guy. What do we got? Sorry about Drew. Most of the time, forget it. What have we got back here? How far can we go? Oh, let's contemplate.
Just a day in the park with Rachel Amber. You know when something kind of amazing is happening, you don't always stop to think about it right away? And then when you do think about it, you start thinking about it a lot. And the more you think about it, the crazier it seems, until pretty soon you're psyching yourself out and then everything turns to shit.
Yeah. Let's not do that today.
Seems good. Alright, let's get up. What's further down? Tire swing, huh?
If Max were here, she'd probably take a black and white photograph and call it Innocence Lost or some shit.
Hey, squirrels! Boo.
Get out of here, woodland creatures. Have some self-respect.
Oh. And then there are birds come in. Birds? Oh, come on, birds.
Bye, you fools.
Anyone, anything else? Oh, the squirrels are back. Huh, alright, fine. What we got?
I've always said the Prescott family has a couple screws loose.
Mm-hmm. As far as we can go? Or no? Initials.
Yuck. Cliche much, AW and OL.
I've been saying sorry all morning. I admit it was really dumb to lock the keys in the car. You've been on me for 3 hours.
Oh. What Oh my god, totem pole?
Whoa. That's badass.
What's
yep, it's official. I'm learning way more ditching school than I ever do in class.
Yep. Oh, hey, wine.
My hierarchy of needs goes pot, then beer, then wine. Still, wino has a classy ring to it.
Mm-hmm.
There's gotta be something freeing about being able to build your home wherever you are, from whatever is around you.
Mm-hmm. Alright, what happens if we talk with these guys? Maybe? Hi.
Hey, spare some change?
Sorry, we might have some leftover food when we're done.
What? No, I'm not... What kind of food?
This place has really gone downhill.
Shh. She's right there.
Gee, thanks. Rude much. Fine, I will go the other way. You're gonna be like that. We got back here.
This Blackwall guy sure liked founding stuff that was already there. Founders keepers, I guess.
Yep. Oh, what do we got now?
Never really killed it with this statue of an explorer guy. Where are all my explorer ladies at, though? Probably at home, washing laundry and spitting out kids. Fuck you, Dwight.
Yeah. Oh, we can graffiti the statue. That must be the dead white guy. Axe.
Don't axe, don't fell.
So what we got? Happy Brat, the old car. Plus prison wall, wherever that one is.
I don't want to head down there just yet.
Okay. Fine. Seems.
Need to get that quarterback. The lonely oak looks lonely. Guess even trees have outcasts.
Yeah. Let's investigate.
Looks like I might be able to pry it open with the right tool.
Now that we have the right tool.
I'm not getting in there with just my fingers. Maybe Rachel has something I can use.
Hi, do you have anything we could use?
I'm thinking about prying open that viewfinder. Got a knife on you?
A knife?
Yeah. My mom took mine.
No. How about a nail file?
I guess you could stab someone with a nail file.
Oh, right.
Sure, let's try it.
Give it a shot. What do you want? What? No, boy. Good enough. See, she's still a jerk. Alright, let's pry this thing open.
Damn it. It always looks so easy in the movies. Wonder if I can find something sturdier to use.
Anything sturdier. Where are those people? Oh wait, can we take the placard off the bench? Aha, unscrew. just throw it to the ground. Gee. Poor nail file.
A dedication plate takes persistence.
Poor. What now? Oh no. Well, at least we made someone happy. Nail file? Nail file! It's gone. Rest in pieces, nail file. Alright. Can we use a dedication plate?
Prescott power, activate.
And you just throw that to the ground, too. You are very good at throwing things to the ground. Game over.
That was enough of a game for me. Your MacGyver skills are second to none. Except, probably, MacGyver.
Now, is this one actually working?
Alright, here's the game. You find some people for us to spy on, and then you and I will act out what they're saying and thinking. That's it? I do that in my head during, like, every class. See? You're a natural. Let's give it a try.
Well, we got a grill.
Hey, what do you say we barbecue some squirrels when we're done here? God, you just have the best ideas.
Yeah, don't worry, think about it. Anything else? There's gotta be something, right? Aha.
Loving this guy. What's he thinking right now?
Super wedgie.
No matter how fast I go, I'll never outwalk this wedgie.
That's so tragic, but also beautiful in its own way.
We got Grill Dad.
What's going on with these two?
Hunting party.
If you want lunch, you're going to have to learn how to skin your own food like a man.
But I don't know how to skin a bald eagle, Dad.
You don't? What the hell are they teaching you in school?
Wow, that was dark. Too dark? Perfect dark.
If you say so. More? Ah, oh, woman.
Sweet beanie. What do you suppose she's thinking?
Looking at pictures of nature.
Sure. The view's great, but I prefer to look at pictures of nature on a computer.
Ugh, the grass around here is so not green enough.
I cannot wait for the machines to take over.
This is fun. Who's next?
What about Lady by the Tree?
Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to hog the viewfinder.
Jackpot.
Commence makeout session in 3, 2, 1. Nailed it. Damn, they are really going at it.
No kidding. Vibrating beds.
Oh, honey. I think we used the vibrating bed for too long. I'm totally seeing double.
Rachel?
What?
Hey, are you alright?
What are we doing?
Excuse me?
Last I checked, you're supposed to be Chloe Price. Yet we've been ditching now for hours, and we haven't even gotten wasted yet. That's got to be against some school ditching rule.
This is kind of sudden, but sure.
Hell yeah.
the honor student wants to show the school delinquent how to party, be my guest.
How gracious of you.
That is really sudden.
They have a bottle of wine. Let's steal it.
Okay. Or we could go try to find a liquor store instead.
No. You shouldn't bring alcohol to a public park if you're not willing to share it with everybody, right? And fuck it. I just want to take something that's not mine. All right.
Okay.
I'm going in. Try to keep up.
Can we help you?
Oh my god!
Alright, let's take it.
Shit. Talk about committing to a performance.
Oh, thank god! Please, this girl is in trouble! Go get help!
Alright.
I need to get these two to focus on Rachel so I can swipe the wine.
What are you waiting for? Go!
Sterilize the wound.
I've seen this kind of thing
before.
Oh
no, they won.
This woman clearly has a wound that needs to be sterilized. Do you happen to have any alcohol? I didn't see a wound. Look closer. In the meantime, I'll search for the booze.
That failed.
Hold on. There's something off about this. Are you girls putting us on?
What?
Rachel! Run!
What the hell?
Oh, well, we got the wine. Clearly, that was the wrong choice, but hey, we got the wine.
So, maybe your acting could use a little work, but at least you committed to the performance.
Thanks.
I could use a drink after trying to keep up with you.
I am excessively sober right now.
Right. Okay. Guess we're leaving.
Somehow getting back. Somehow. There's some way back. Right. Oh yeah, just walk the tracks. That's not gonna take a while.
Whoa.
Hey, check this out. What?
It's a junkyard.
Great. It's a pile of trash.
Yeah, an awesome pile of trash.
Let's explore. You have fun, Chloe. I'm gonna go sit down.
Rachel's been acting kind of standoffish ever since we left the park. What's her deal?
No kidding. Let her be.
Chloe, I'd really like some space right now.
Okay.
Okay. Actually, no. I thought we were having a great day together. Why are you acting like this all of a sudden?
I'm not acting like anything. I just want to be left alone right now.
I don't understand.
No. I don't understand. You can't just turn on me for no reason.
I'm sorry, turn on you? I guess I forgot. It's always about how you feel, isn't it? Sad Chloe's fucking sad again. Maybe you should try giving a shit about other people for once. Are you serious right now? Fuck!
Okay, I still have no idea what's going on with Rachel, but apparently she gets smashy when she's angry. I can work with that. Score.
Give her a show.
Check it out. I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer drinking it next to an old toilet.
Home run!
Can I see?
Sure.
I asked you to leave me alone.
Are you kidding me? I know you're the school princess and all, with the DA daddy and the perfect grades and all the perfect little Victoria Chases kissing your perfect ass, but seriously, fuck you.
Great. I'm leaving. See you around, Chloe.
You can't leave!
Watch me.
Rachel, wait! Don't go. Why not? Because I don't want to ruin this the way I ruin everything else in my life. And what is this exactly?
A friendship.
A real friendship.
I thought Chloe Price doesn't need friends.
I thought so too before today. I guess it's easier to be alone if you decide it's a choice.
I'm sorry.
For whatever I did or didn't do, today was the best day I've had since my dad died. And I screwed it up somehow. Like I screw everything up, because I'm a fucking screw-up.
Chloe, please. I don't want to be alone anymore.
Just wanted a friend, and I can respect that.
I'm sorry.
I know how it is,
Chloe,
to be alone.
I can't say why, and I know it isn't fair. But I can't be your friend right now.
Can't or don't want to.
Does it matter? I'm really sorry. Goodbye, Chloe.
Sure seemed to want to be friends earlier.
This place.
I think on that note, I'm going to end it there. Chloe's a little mad. Oh boy, what does mom want? You know why? Principal meeting tomorrow. You do better, Chloe. Chloe! Worry about you. Please let me know you're okay. Not really that okay, actually. Happy brat, guilt car. Alright. Yeah, like I said, I'm gonna leave it there. So, thank you for watching, In the next part, we will go smash some stuff up, I guess. So yeah, if you enjoyed the episode, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe down below. If you'd like to help support the channel, and it would mean a lot to me if you did, be sure to go check out my Patreon or my Gotbox. Both are great ways, and Gotbox is also free. So, there you go. And if you'd like to find me on social media, I am on Twitter, Facebook, and Twitch, where I stream 5 days a week. And all the links for this stuff are down in the description. So yeah, thank you all for watching. And until next time, this is Rin the MT, signing out.